In early 2009, the U.S. was in the midst of the Great Recession, and one of President Obama's first acts as president was signing the American Recovery and Reinvestment Act on February 17, 2009. This is popularly known as the stimulus. Well, an influential and extremely famous theory in macroeconomics says that if you increase government spending during a recession, that will increase employment and help end recessions sooner. So, what we wanted to know in 2009 was, will passing this act, the stimulus, increase employment and end this recession? Well, Christina Romer, the chair of Obama's Council of Economic Advisors, and Jared Bernstein, the chief economist for Vice President Joe Biden, they made predictions about what would happen to the unemployment rate, both with and without the stimulus. So that's what I've got right here. On the vertical axis, I've got the unemployment rate, and on the horizontal axis, I've got time. So from 2007, 2008, up to quarter one, 2009, that's the past. They made these predictions in 2009, quarter one. So they had the data on the true unemployment rate up until then. Then they made predictions about what would the unemployment rate be with the stimulus. That's in this solid line here. They also made a prediction about what would happen without the stimulus. That's this solid upper line right here. So they see that with the stimulus, unemployment rate is lower, and therefore we should pass the stimulus if we want to end this recession. So what happened? Well, the stimulus actually was passed. So let's look at the data. Here in the red line, red dots, I've got the actual unemployment rate. And as we can see, it actually went all the way up to 10% and then finally started leveling off down now at about 7.8% in late 2012. So that's a lot higher than actually both of their predictions, either with or without the stimulus. So what happened? Why were the predictions so wrong? Well, let's go back to early 2009 and ask, how should we make these predictions? Well, unfortunately, we can't run an experiment. We only have one country, and recessions are often countrywide or even global. So we can't take some countries and randomize them to get a stimulus and other countries and randomize them to not get a stimulus. We just can't do it. So instead, what macroeconomists do is they try to construct a very detailed model of the economy using various theories about how the economy works. Now, this model is going to have treatment variables, like government spending, and outcome variables, like the unemployment rate. Once we've got the model, the second step is fitting the model to the past data. Then, once we've got our fitted model, the third and final step is to make predictions about what outcomes will occur if we change different treatments. Now, that's exactly what Romer and Bernstein did. Now, this is also what the Federal Reserve does to inform every policy decision it makes. So, why were our predictions so wrong? Well, they faced an enormously difficult task. You know, making a macroeconomic prediction requires predicting the aggregate behavior of literally billions of people. So, you know, as the sociologist Duncan Watts says, social science is not rocket science. It's a whole lot harder. Landing people on the moon is really easy, but answering causal questions in social science, especially macroeconomics, is very, very difficult. So there's actually a lot of uncertainty in our predictions about the effects of various economic policies because it's so difficult. So unfortunately, one of the problems with this Romer and Bernstein chart is that they didn't attempt to quantify the uncertainty in their prediction at all, even though in their paper they did say, quote, "we confess to considerable uncertainty about our choice of parameters," unquote. So really, they know that macroeconomics is hard and our predictions have a lot of uncertainty. So if they had shown the same plot with that uncertainty, it's definitely possible that the true data would have lied within their bounds of uncertainty. So that's pretty much what happened. Macroeconomics is hard. So what can we conclude from this finding? You know, does the data show that the stimulus was bad? Well, no. Why? Remember, to answer causal questions, we need to know the counterfactual. What's the counterfactual of what would have happened if the stimulus wasn't passed? We don't know, because it was passed. We don't have any data. So we can't, from our data, learn whether the stimulus was good or not. So unfortunately, we're just never ever going to know what that data would have been, because that's a counterfactual outcome. We also will not know What would have happened if the stimulus was even stronger, as some people like Paul Krugman suggested it should have been? So the best hope we can do is try to continue to refine our macroeconomic models and our understandings of the processes of how the economy works, and try to slowly chip away at these difficult problems.